Madam, I stand to oppose the bill because this is a disrespect. By bringing such a bill, the government is disrespecting our freedom fighters. The freedom fighters wanted the country to be independent from the clutches of the Britishers, not only for independence, but to ensure that we have due process and we follow rule of law. This is what the government is attacking. Madam, this bill violates Article 14 and 21. The government is taking over the judicial independence under Article, which is guaranteed under Article 50. You are a lawyer, Madam Chairperson. Now, as the law present stands, if I am called a terrorist, I can only be called a terrorist after a court convicts me. It cannot be on the basis of the feelings of the government or on the mere suspension. I have to be given a judgment by a court of law. Then only I'm called a terrorist. Now, what this government is doing, bona fide, they don't have any bona fide. You suspect on your feelings, you call X a terrorist, and there are not many legal consequences, but social ostracization, police knocking at 2 a.m. in the morning, the area people telling, please vacate the flat or the house because you are called a terrorist. And what is the procedure, madam? 35, in 35, section 35, government says, we'll call you a terrorist. 36, I appeal. The government rejects it. Then the government forms a review committee. The review committee rejects. Where is the independence?
Then you have judicial.
Exactly, there is no judicial scrutiny. And madam, you know,
judicial review is there. Sorry for intervention.
No, you're absolutely right. I agree with you. I agree with you, madam. Madam, you know very well the seminal case, the seminal case of V.J. Roe. When it came to unlawful organization, the Supreme Court said that designation without judicial review is unconstitutional. Here you have no judicial scrutiny. You know the case of Manika Gandhi. Without falling judicial scrutiny, it is against principle of natural justice. What will happen? You will be destroying an Indian's reputation, freedom and personality without procedure laid down by CRPC. Second point, madam. Second point. Clause A11 of bill provides, as amended from time to time. I mean, where is the parliament sovereignty going? You are saying that any international law which is formed will implement. Madam, the law has to be passed in our parliament, subscribing the punishment of. You are giving it, you are outsourcing your nationalism to some international convention. Is this the nationalism of the government? I strongly oppose this Clause A11, and it undermines the dualist nature of Indian polity. Thirdly, you talk about international law. Madam, you know for a fact that we have signed and ratified ICCPR, ICSCR. What do they say? They clearly say that a fair trial is required. Here in this UAPA, presumption of guilt is on the accused. Even if I am silenced, that is taken as my guilt. That is a clear violation of ICCPR Article 14, madam. Please look into it. You don't talk about that. You talk about Security Council resolutions. Madam, Security Council 1373 clearly says you cannot violate ICCPR. Security Council 1535 resolution says any law you make to counter terrorism must comply with international law and human rights. Again, you violate it. Fourth point, madam. You know, you have zero tolerance for terrorism. May I ask very respectfully to the Honorable Home Minister, what about your zero tolerance towards miscarriage of justice? Recent example, 3 days ago, four boys from Amroha were released by NIA after spending 7 months. Now, will you suspend those officers? You cannot suspend. Madam, you know, please allow me, madam. Please.
I've already given you 1 minute extra.
No, but please,
extra.
Madam. I request you, madam. Please, give me two, three minutes. Madam, there's 197 CRPC, 451 CRPC, which will not allow you to suspend the officials. Only what is the remedy for me? Article 311. Will you suspend those NIA officers? No, you will not do it. And I blame Congress party for this. They are the ones, they are the main culprits for bringing this law. They are the ones. And when they are in power, they are bigger than BJP. When they lose power, they become big brother of Muslims. That is my tragedy. You have made such laws that you come and take it to its logical conclusion. And madam, my fifth point is seizure of property. Please again see, madam. Seizure of property. Where is the judicial scrutiny? Can a policeman apply a judicial mind? No. And then you are violating federalism. State property, how can an NIA take? That's a violation of federalism. And Madam Bail, please understand, I will not get bail because I have to satisfy the court. I have to satisfy the court that I'm innocent. But may I point out to you, madam, a Supreme Court case of 2018, Nikesh Chand Tarachand, the bail provision in this act and the PMLA Act are completely ad verbatim. In that, the Supreme Court said in PMLA that it is drastic, draconian, it reverses the presumption of innocence. Will you follow this that act, that Supreme Court judgment? We don't know. And madam, Section 58 was there in POTA. Again, Congress party. Mr. Chidambaram, I pleaded with him from here. Sir, don't pass this law. But I was told, no, you don't know about national interest. Now Congress party sits here and sermonizes. You did not even send that 2008 bill. You did not even send that 2008 bill to the standing committee. Who are the victims? I wish and pray that a topmost Congress leader should go under UAPA and spend at least 10 months. Then they'll realize. Then they'll realize my pain. My pain. Madam, let me remind you. I'm concluding. Madam,
In any case, Mr. Owaisi's time is up. Yes. Tell me the rule. Tell me the rule.
The same rule you read. I asked the same privilege that honourable member of Parliament Aluwalia.
Let's.
The same rule.
Two lines.
Please. If I don't put forward my pain over here, where should I go? Please tell me. I have been a victim of this act, madam. Not these people. I have been a victim. My livelihood has been destroyed. Please give me 2 minutes. I plead with you. Madam.
Finish.
I conclude. Madam, I don't want any respect from Congress party. I don't want. I am good enough for that because saying. Now,
Adhirji, and Mr. Owaisi.
I'm concluding.
Just conclude.
UAPA, nothing else. In this law, we have created a world record. The police detention is for 6 months. Nowhere in the world it is like this. Nowhere in the world, madam. UK 28 days. USA, the oldest democracy, headed by a prick, a bluff master called Donald Duck, has only two days, madam. You are loving Donald Duck? Madam, Home Minister, may I remind the Home Minister, tough laws. You want tough laws. May I ask the Honorable Home Minister, you were the Home Minister when Akshardham took place. 4 boys lost 11 years. Who killed those people in Akshardham Mandir? No one knows. But it is the 4 boys who lost their 11 years, madam. That is why I say that IPC is good enough. A bad craftsman will blame its tools. I conclude by saying that we endorse Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And in that end of Universal Declaration of Human Rights was said that man has a right to rebel against tyranny. These laws will force people to rebel against tyranny. You are following in the rightful steps of Congress party. I welcome that. You have seen their state. It is up to you. I conclude by dedicating this speech to those people who have lost their livelihood under this draconian act. History will absolve me, as Castro said, madam, and I hope that this government will have a zero tolerance on miscarriage of justice, because we have not got justice from either BJP in power or Congress in power. All such draconian laws have only been used against Muslims and Dalits, which has been very unfortunate. I condemn both of these parties. Thank you, madam.